Hey everyone, welcome to Hungry Mother State Park. I am Ranger Tanya and I'm going to show you what we do behind the scenes when we're not giving interpretive programs. One thing we have here at Hungry Mother, we have some animals here and we need to take care of them daily. And so one of the chores that we have to do is we have to clean tanks. So one of the animals we have here is a common snapping turtle. And an eastern painted turtle. And then we also have the eastern hellbender, which is the third largest salamander in the world. So you're not going to be able to see him right now because we actually have started cleaning his aquarium, and we made him a little habitat of his own in the bucket. We put water from the tank, and then we also put his air bubbler because he likes lots of oxygen, and we also put the lid on him because we actually almost lost him. So anyhow, he's nice and safe in his habitat. So now what we're going to do is we're going to clean his tank. We have to clean his tank because due to the environment that he's around, the algae builds up in the tank, and so we need to clean it out, make sure we keep his chemicals right. Hellbenders like very oxygenated water, and they also like water that is below 70 degrees. So we have this chiller down here that we keep him about 69 degrees, which is the perfect temperature he loves. And then we also have, like I said, oxygen being put into the water, so he has that high oxygenated water. Now, the one thing that we do, I know that we have to clean his tank because I have done the water testing. I've tested the chemicals in his tank, and we found out that the nitrate levels are way too high. So when the nitrate levels are too high, we have to change his water out. And we get the water from the lake outside because his natural environment is pretty much what we have out here at Hungry Mother State Park. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to clean the tank, and then we will fill the water back up, and then we'll put the hellbender back in. So one of the first things we have to do is we have to get the water out of the tank. And we're not going to remove all of the water. Just remember, we're only going to remove part of the water, probably about two-thirds of the tank. Now I've already removed a lot. This is where the fun part comes in, the siphon. Usually Tanya drenches herself sometime within this process. So let's see if we can get this working. Leftover shrimp. I just put this morning, so this isn't too bad. He still might eat that. During the winter times, it's really hard to find the hellbender's favorite food, which is a crawdad. A lot of people around here, the fishermen, will actually kill hellbenders because they think they eat all the trout. But actually, hellbenders prefer crawdads. So that's their very favorite food. That's what they go after the most. But during the winter time, when we can't find crawdads because they're under the banks and under the ground, we feed him shrimp, and he usually likes that pretty well. So this hellbender eats pretty fine. As you can see, this isn't a job for somebody that doesn't like to get dirty or wet. But usually by the end of the day, I'm soaked after doing the cages or the tanks. But we do try to get all the rocks with all the algae buildup and all the other gunk off of it, so we can give them a nice clean environment. So after we're done cleaning off the rocks, then we have to come back and rebuild the habitat for Hungars. So what we're going to do is I'm going to bring all the rocks back in and I'm going to put them back in his tank. And we're going to prepare him so that he has some place to crawl under. Because remember, hellbenders live up underneath the flat rocks. So if you're ever out in the creek and you're playing around and you're moving rocks, well, be very aware that if you move a rock, then you need to kind of put that rock back just where it was, because if a hellbender lived under there and you move it, then they might not produce eggs the following year. So again, make sure you always put your rocks back where they come from. So what I'm going to do now is we're just going to create a nice little habitat. And remember also, so they like flat rocks, they like a lot of oxygen in their water. They have to have free-flowing streams. That's why they like this area. And also they have to have under 70 degrees water. So that's why we have a chiller here to keep the water cold enough for the hellbender year-round. So I'm going to put these rocks back in and make them a habitat. Now, I am going to try to hold him for just a second, but he's a salamander. He's quick, and I'm going to have to get in his tank fairly quick. So, but hopefully he'll swim around a little bit, and you guys will get a good view of him. And remember, he's the third largest salamander in the world. This is usually his time that he sleeps. So he's probably going to go and hopefully try to find a place to go to sleep, because he is nocturnal. Maybe he'll be a little slower. Now, I think he feels very, very soft. Some people think salamanders feel very slimy, but I think he's very soft. He's got a lot of extra skin because he breathes through his skin. That's why he needs so much oxygen in his water and very little. He doesn't need any pollution or chemicals because he will take that through his skin, and that can kill a salamander. So, again. Say hello to Hungars. Whoop, but he's going in. As you can see, he likes his home. He goes right in underneath his rocks. Now his tail, a lot of times, they'll leave their tail out from underneath the rocks because they have a lot of light sensors in their tail. Get a good view of him there. Now we received Hungars. The Aquatic Wildlife Conservation Center that's located out at Bowler's Fish Hatchery, sorry about that. They had replacing mussels in the creek, and they found a hellbender's nest, a bunch of eggs, abandoned. They know that the male hellbender always stays with the eggs, so for some reason that nest had been abandoned, so they took the eggs and they reared them up. Once they reared them up, I think they had about 6 or 7 hellbenders. They couldn't keep them all there at Bowler's Fish Hatchery, so they decided to adopt them out. Look at his feet, aren't they just adorable? Now some of the hellbenders were tested and they had a fungus called chytrid. And chytrid is actually in low levels. It's a kind of an infection that affects salamanders and other amphibians. And it's actually in the wild at low levels. But since some of these hellbenders actually have the chytrid fungus, we can't release him back into the wild. So he has become an education animal here, an ambassador, we'll say, here at Hungry Mother State Park. The one way we were able to get them was from the Lego, it was the first Lego League in Abingdon. It was the fifth grade, the comments from the fifth grade in Abingdon, they actually purchased all the equipment along with the Friends of Hungry Mother. They all purchased the equipment, all of our materials that we needed, and provided the habitat for Hungars. So, but again, we have to do this tank cleaning usually at least once a month, sometimes occasionally more. But as you can see, Hungars seems to be pretty happy.